about it. The first one is learning and innovation. So, Kibaki University, creativity, innovation, critical thinking and problem solving, communication and collaboration. Very, very important. So those skills are universal. In fact, they were prepared by a team from UNESCO over a period of 7 years working on these skills. In other words, if you want to be a human being functional in the 21st century, you must have learning and innovation in your curriculum. The other one is information technology. And again, we are lucky here. Information and technology, information literacy, media literacy, ICT literacy. So, the students in this room, just ask yourself, how are my IT skills? How am I on the keyboard of the computer? So instead of going on my stories, you sit down and get to familiarize yourself with the keyboard. Now, just by a show of hand, how many of us students, how many of us have their own laptop? This is scary. Very scary. And I know we have laptop, we have labs, and so on. You must work towards that. And if you don't have a laptop, then you must sit, you must spend more time in those ICT rooms so that you are thorough with the packages that are needed. Now, the next one, this one in that corner is very important, this one. The life and career skills. We expect all of us, and particularly the students, to be flexible and adaptable. You must be able to socialize across culture. You must be productive and accountable. You must have leadership and responsibility. And for me, the most important thing is to lift your emotional intelligence. So the Kibabi, can we be ahead of the pack? Like at this and now, all programs have been revised to infuse a very heavy dose of emotional intelligence. The world will not hire you today because you have a degree. That is IQ. The world will hire you today because you are empathic, because you are flexible, because you can relate to other people very well. Emotional intelligence. And this one is a must. As the earlier you integrate it, the better. And leadership and responsibility also should improve that. But let me pause there and just show you this clip. And then I want to hear from you, why are we showing this clip? Yeah, it's about 6 minutes. I hope it is here. By the way, IQ, the fact that you have a very high IQ, you are very brilliant in the head, will give you a job. But it is your EQ, your emotional intelligence, that will see you succeed in that job. And so, faculty, when we are teaching, you don't teach emotional intelligence by talking about it. No, you don't.
You teach emotional intelligence
experientially. So let's watch this. It will take us about 6 minutes.
Yeah, I just kind of want to focus purely on emotion when I hear
story.
And it really helps.
Yeah, my focal point is my mom. Her birthday is Sunday, and she passed away. Yeah, so this is the reason why I'm here. This is the moment that I've been waiting for. The moment that my mother would be proud to see me accomplished.
I was 14, going on the age of 15, when I got the devastating news that my mother was murdered. It was the worst moment of my life. I visited her grave this year, and I talked to her. I told her all the things that were going on, but it's something that you never get over, because you want your mom here cheering you on for those moments that mean so much to you. I know that my mom is looking at me. She's proud. She's proud.
You can be a very intelligent person, But if you don't have a heart that cares, you will never flourish to become what God intended you to become. And so, as we teach the 21st century skills, we would like to see a sense of optimism, a sense of happiness within your students. And that must be put in the curriculum. Now, this clip I've shown you of Ashley, this one. I just want to ask the students who are here, what drives you? What is your purpose? You know, if all the students here had a very strong purpose, if in our curriculum we emphasize emotional intelligence, we shall strengthen the purpose of the students. So what is your purpose? This girl, her purpose was, she was aware of the fact that her mother was killed. And that gave her the drive to do what the mother would have liked to see her become or do. Now, I know some of you students here come from backgrounds like mine. Because me, I grew up in the slums of Kibera. Son of a driver. And we stayed with my father in one room in Kibera. And every morning, there was a Nubian lady, and by she would go to the panga, I used to make between 4:30 in the morning and 5:30. I would have made I would make 100 chapatis every day to be given 2 shillings and 50 cents. I used to walk 7 kilometers from like Saba in Kibera to Upper in school, at least. So my purpose was that I have really worked hard to get my father out of the slum. That time I kept on asking, how come my mother doesn't come to visit my father? Wondering. Now I realize, how could she have come and we were staying in one room? It was not possible for her to come and see the husband. But I'm saying something very serious here. Many of you in Kibabi University now, some of you are lucky you are sons or daughters of professors like Ayo, or principal, or magistrate, or lawyer. You come from privileged homes. But I know many of you here, sitting here, have my background from poor background. Maybe not the slum, but you come from a home where there's nothing. But you see, because you have not lifted your emotional intelligence, you come here and you pretend. You socialize your guilt. You walk with people who you shouldn't be walking with. You begin to want to use what is that so called? Castles, whatever, imperial leather. Instead of using sunlight, you want to use imperial leather. Because your other friend is using it. So if you are girls, you become victims of exploitation. Yeah, because you want to use that perfume that other person is using. How do you get it? So as we talk CBC, I keep repeating values and emotional intelligence. The boys here, you know there are people, there are students. When I was at Moi, the parents come for graduation. The fourth year, they're coming for graduation, but there's no graduation. Somebody has been getting money and buying phones for the girlfriend and doing all that for 4 years. And parents then discover when they come to the office, the registrar says, this person, we have no records. The only records we have are the marks in the first year. We are talking about emotional intelligence. So as I talk about CBC, remember the country is looking for ways of raising our value system as a nation. So this clip just shows you when you have a strong purpose. You will not be confused. You have a purpose. You want something different for yourself. I want to emphasize that that is one of the strongest skills of the 21st century. And by the way, people are no longer looking for the so-called bright people. That boy is very bright, that girl is very bright. No. People are looking for men and women of character and values. That's what we're looking for in the world of tomorrow. So I just want to finish with this slide, then we'll take a break and come back for the second session. I've combined the first two sessions. And I want you to look at this study. This is now a research study. This is a study I did when I was doing my postdoctoral studies in Texas A&M University in the US. I was looking at specific high schools in Kenya, and I was looking at the success of those schools and the leader in that school. And what was I measuring? I was not measuring the IQ of the principals of those schools, no. Because all those principals have degrees. Some have masters, some have PhDs today. So the IQ is above average for all of them. So I was measuring the emotional intelligence. In fact, I'm beginning to, if you can Google, my under Google Scholar, you'll find I've done a lot of work in this area. You'll find this. Even now, I'm pushing the Teacher Service Commission, Public Service Commission. Let more people come for interviews where you are asking them questions about remembering and understanding. No. Let them do a psychometric test and measure their EQ, their emotional intelligence. Because that is what brings leadership. By the way, you don't have to have a PhD to have these beautiful grounds. Yeah, you must have a heart to know that I'm a custodian of the Republic of Kenya, so I must make this place look good. That has nothing to do with your IQ. That is matters of the heart. So, I was looking at the results of some selected schools in Kenya, but I was looking at schools that are very good, where parents want their children to go because of sports, because of academic performance, because of discipline, and just the wellness of a school. So, we measured emotional intelligence versus performance as an aggregate. And those who have done statistics, we got those scattered points, those blue points and scattered points. And in statistics, we draw the line of best fit through those. You draw the line that each of them is closest to. If you do a line of best fit, that yellow line, get a statistical value, R squared. R squared is the coefficient of regression. The R-squared value for this particular research was 0.6621. What does that mean? It means that 66.2% of success of a school depends on the emotional intelligence of the principal. 66%. So what does that tell us? It tells us that emotional intelligence is a greater determiner of success than IQ. So Ibabi, your mission, my colleague managers here, my mission is to, for you to make Ibabi just a unique public university by lifting the emotional intelligence of this young and strong university. These students will just be different. They will just be different. And I want you to note that even when you go for employment, imagine if I had advertised for a job, all of you would come with your degree. So what would make, how would I choose the difference? The next level now would be to measure the EQ of the students we're dealing with. The next level is to look at the recommendation from Kibabi University about this person. The next level is to hear from your pastor whether you attend church service or not. Sounds awkward, eh? Sounds awkward. For me to become vice chancellor of this, my pastor in Everett had to write a letter of confirmation that you can trust this man with this university pastor. That pastor doesn't even have a degree. He doesn't have. But now I look back and I see it is useful. It is very useful. I urge Kibabi, as part of the CBC, to begin to infuse constructs, attributes of emotional intelligence into your curriculum. And don't be shy to stick to those values. Let me give you an example. Today, I have my biggest headache in Nairobi as Vice Chancellor of Leicester is a university called Strathmore University. Leicester was the first private university to be chartered by the government in 1994. Chartered. Strathmore is not even 10 years old. But today, Strathmore has a waiting list. Yeah. Parents want their sons and daughters to go to Strathmore. Does it mean I don't have brilliant professors to teach business at this time? So what's the difference? What is the difference? Strathmore has lifted the EQ. That's why they have a dress code. In Strathmore, you don't wear anything. You don't just go anyhow. Why do you think parents pay very high fees in Leicester, for example? Why? Why do parents pay? You know, our fees in Leicester is very high. That's why I've looked for scholarships. I have hooked students like this one. Now I have about 1,300. The fees from government cannot meet the requirements of Leicester. So I have to look for scholarships for these students because they're also the brightest. They are heroes of tomorrow. So, why do you think parents pay almost three times as much as a public university place for their child to be in this? Why? They are looking for certain values. Yeah, they are looking for certain values. So, Kibabi, through a deliberate desire to implement CBC, you can lift the value system of this university to another level. And the good thing is that you are still a nice small university of 7,000. That's a very nice small university. It's not like a university of 50,000 students, 30,000. 7,000, we can almost know each other. But the difference between us, the difference between us and that other university is not the IQ, because there are professors like us. They get students from all over the country like us. The difference will be the emotional intelligence levels in this university. That brings me to the first end of the first section.
We'll take a break, and let's not take long, let's come back and we'll finish the workshop. Thank you very much, and God bless you.
Mark one from your students. There's no way.